There are two things we have invented. We call them MedMon and Secure Vibe. There is an area called Internet of Things. These things are devices that connect to the internet. It's projected that there'll be $6 trillion impact on the world economy per year by 2025. And 1.5 trillion of those would be coming from implantable and wearable medical devices and sensors and objects of that sort. MedMon is short for medical monitor. This device will monitor all the signals that are coming towards the implantable and wearable medical devices on your body and make sure that they are not malicious. If they are malicious, they'll be jammed. The second item is Secure Vibe. So one issue with these devices is one could just say, why don't we encrypt all the data? And that much energy is not available. For example, if it's a pacemaker and I put security on the pacemaker, but that drains the battery much faster, then instead of every 10 years, I'll have to have surgery every maybe 5 years to change the battery, and that has its own attendant risks. We have to do security with energy efficiency, and that is what makes this problem very difficult. So in Secure Vibe, we try to address this problem by showing a way to exchange the keys that are needed for encryption very energy efficiently. So that is a complementary technology to MedMon. MedMon tackles the problem of integrity, which is a malicious packet should not be sent to the device without being recognized. And Secure Vibe addresses confidentiality, where if someone is trying to eavesdrop on your device, then he or she will not be able to do so. They'll be monitoring our health 24/7. So we'll collect the data from these sensors, send it to our smartphone, which will be connected to the internet. It'll be uploaded to a health server where a physician can look at all of that data to make sure that you're doing okay. Security becomes an important concern because the technology will not be adopted if the data can be eavesdropped upon, or much worse than that, actually harm me. There are three pillars of security. One is confidentiality, then integrity, and availability. Somebody else can find out what your health condition is, so that's confidentiality being breached. Integrity is if you send a command or a wireless packet to these devices that make them do something that is not allowed. For example, an insulin pump, you can tell the insulin pump to pump in too much insulin into the body. And this malicious packet, if it is not recognized, it can do a lot of harm. And availability is just, even when an attack is going on, can you have normal operation of the device? So it's very important that all these three pillars be addressed. The security of IoT actually keeps me awake at night, because just like internet was not built with security in mind, we may be about to make the same mistake with Internet of Things if we don't take security into account from the very beginning. We'd like to make sure that IoT is introduced widely, but introduced in a secure way so that it cannot be hacked.